Okay, hi everybody. Actually this video that I was doing with the twins got deleted, which sucks. Okay, so I'll show you the twins. Now I messed it up because this is twin one, and she could either be a boy or a girl. And then they have this cute little indent in them, which actually makes it good for rooting, which is good, which will help me out a lot. And the eyes. They're all sleeping eyes, so I can go and I can root it. And a little mouth, and a little nose. Her nose is... I gotta drill holes in her nose, but I don't know if I want to. Her little ear. And her little neck creases. And her little bald head, which I want to root, but I don't know. Depends. And then we got twin two. Could be a boy or a girl. I'm not sure yet. Kind of looks like Zinni, which is weird. But with open mouth Zinni. I don't know. Looks weird. It's cool. It's pretty cool. And then we got some wrinkles over here, creases. We got little tiny back of the head. We got, oh, this one has a mark too that I could go and I could use to root. Nice. Okay, and then we have the, they both come with the same body, which is the body is right here. And I think that's the back or the front. Yeah, this is the back. This is the front. No, that's the back and this is the front. That's the front. Okay, and then they have little feet. Here's her little feet. Very cute. Oh, look at the creases. Wow. That is pretty cool, the creases. Oh, and the arms. This is the arms of the first kit, which is cute. There's a closed fist, which is really cute. And the other one's an open fist. I mean, the other one's open, not open fist, open arm. So, hold on a minute. Sorry about that. Hold on, I'm trying to, like, hold the camera and take things out at the same time. It's kind of hard. There's the hand. They have a hand, open hand. I think they have the same hands. I'm not sure. I think they have the same feet, too. Wait, hold on. Yeah, they have the same feet. Yep, they have the same feet. So you really don't have to see the hands and the feet because you saw the hands and the feet. So they have the same hands and the feet. They have the same body, but they have different heads. Okay, so that's that. That's the first kit. Okay. I want to go put that away. So let me go put it away. And if they have nothing, they don't have any marks on them or anything, which is great. Okay, so we're going to do that. So I'm going to go and I'm going to put that away. Okay, where's the hand? Where's the hand? Where's the other hand? Oh, yeah, this is the other hand. Okay. This is the other hand and the foot. Okay. This is the hand and the foot of the other kit. Okay, and we'll put that into the twin number two bag, and we'll put the head in, and the body in, and that's the head and the body, okay, and that's that, that's one, and then I'm going to put in the other one, and then the other one, okay, and then this is the other one, I'm going to put the other one away. And this is the arms and legs and the hands over here, okay? And the body, okay? So I'm going to put the other one away. I don't know which one I'm doing tomorrow. I think I might do the one with the closed mouth. I'm not sure. Or I might do Zinni. I'm not sure. Hi, honey. Hi. How you doing? Oh, there's my hubby.
Hi.
You really can't see him that well. And we're getting ready to go to bed soon.
Hi.
Okay, and this is the Zinni kit. This is the one that I told you before, the one that is a 242 out of 420. And here's Zinni's arms. And they are really, really cute. They're just the same one as Sam. And then here's her legs. Well, his are her legs. I'm not sure if I'm making a boy or a girl. There's the legs. And then we have the head. The body's coming in the mail. I don't have the body yet. Oh, how cute is that face? I get to root her eyelashes and paint her. I don't know which one should I paint first. I don't even know. I think I might just paint... Maybe I'll paint Zinni first. I'm not sure. I'm not really sure what I want to do yet. I don't know if I'm going to paint Zinni or I'm going to paint one of the twins. I'm not sure. Okay, so now here's... I also wanted to show you my paints because I want to show you what I use. Okay, hold on a minute. I'll be right back. Alright, so this is my paint box and all my other stuff. Okay, this is just, you know, random plate directions that I don't even use because I make up stuff as I go. Cups for the Olo's paint thinner. We got, this is the Bountiful Baby paint. And inside here, hold on a minute. Inside here is the, oh, I think I just closed it. No, I opened it. Okay. This is the baby brown for the, that's the eyebrows. This is the burnt umber, which is for the eyebrows, I think, so. This is the matte varnish. Here's the veins, the Bountiful Baby veins. Bountiful Baby skin color. Bountiful Baby warm blush. Bountiful Baby blush and nail and lips. This is the air gloss varnish, which I've never used. I've never used this. It's brand new. So I don't know. Oh, and this is the authentic strawberry lip, because I don't know what it's doing in here. I don't know. I guess because this is all the other stuff that I am looking at. Okay. Well, this is what I was selling, but I decided not to because I wanted to try it. Yeah. So I'm going to try it, see if I like it. I use Authentic Reborn paint, but we'll see if I like the Bountiful Baby. I used the Bountiful Baby on the tummy plate, which came out great. These are just, you know, craft sticks for the mixing paint. These are the sponges, and that's for the baby modeling, which I still have a problem because every single time I go to, like, model, it's like I'm using too much paint, so I have to put it on lighter because otherwise it's going to make the baby look bruised. Then I got the cosmetic sponges because I like the cosmetic sponges. They help me, even though people say that you're not really supposed to use them because they're not really that great, but they like to use the, like, I don't know, mop brushes or whatever or stuff like that. This is the Authentic Reborn paint, and I have a whole bunch of it. I mean, that's why I like it better. This is the Authentic Reborn Shine Remover for in case the baby's shiny. This is the vein. You can tell that the difference between this blue and the other blue is that the other blue is darker. This blue is lighter. Then I have the Authentic Reborn Moist Glaze, which I've never used it. Plus, I just bought another one. So I might sell that one if anybody wants it. I don't know. I'm not sure yet. We got the Bountiful Baby Nail Tip. We've got the skin texture, which I use with the 3D effects and also with the 3D effects. I think this is Moisture Glaze Medium as well. I'm not even sure. Or maybe this is Color Thinner? I don't even know. Then we have, this is the Color Thinner Medium. This is the Clear Matte Coat Sealer, which is for the, this is 3D texture. The Matte Sealer is to seal the paint so it doesn't go and get all, you know, what's that word? So it doesn't rub off. This is the Skin Texture Foundation, which that's the, this is with the 3D paint. This is Color Thinner Medium. It thins the color out. And this is 3D Texture. I bought another one because this way I have two because I was running out the second one. So I bought some more paints. The big jars are $9.99 each by Dolls by Sandy. And the petite jars are like $4. And all these paints cost me a lot of money. I mean, I want to get rid of some of them so I can make some money because, you know, sometimes I buy stuff impulsively and then I end up not even using it and I'll just sell it on eBay when I don't want to use it. So I will go through these and I'll let you know if I have some for sale and if some of my Reborn Artist friends would like to either they need an extra color and they don't feel like going to buy like one like for regular price, maybe I could slash it down to like instead of paying $9.99, I'll give it to you like for $5 or something like that. I don't know. I'll let you know. It depends on what I want to sell. I don't even know what I want to sell now. I'll let you know. But none of these paints are for sale yet. I don't know. Because some of them I want to use and some of them I don't want to, so I don't know. This is supposed to be like the creases and wrinkles. And this is supposed to be another creases and wrinkles. I don't like the color. I think the color is too dark. And that might be used for like lips or something like that. This is lips too. No, this is blush. And then we have this, which is Flush 06, which is the Or flesh of five? No, flesh of six. This is these are for like biracial kits, which I was doing a biracial kit with Danielle, which was the Brieringer that's awake that you saw. I want to do a biracial, but the only problem is they come so dark. See, what I gotta do is I gotta color. I gotta make it like a light color. That's what I need. I want a light brown color. I wanted to do one of the twins a little bit brown, but you know, I gotta get the right. What I gotta do is I gotta go and I gotta test the paints and make sure that the paints are really, really nice color, because I don't want to like layer it, you know, two different colors, because that will look stupid. And then I have the Brow Brown, and this is the one that is Authentic Reborn. These are Authentic Reborn paints. They're a little bit different. And this is Flesh 07. This is a new one that I wanted to try out. This one is actually a paint that my sister made using like a whole bunch of stuff. And this is Flesh 05. And then this is Flesh 0. This is the paint that my sister made. Okay? Those are all my paints. Let me see if I have anything else to show you in my paint / sponge / reborn supply box. Let's see what else. Oh, I have a beating heart, which I got from Bountiful Baby. I have a hands-free magnifying glass. And these are just Krylon paint wipe removers. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. Gloves. And the neck ring for Sophia, and more gloves that came with my dyeing hair product, because I dyed my hair. Oh yeah, I dyed my hair. Do you see? I don't know if you can tell. I dyed my hair.